I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. In this video, I will show you how to calculate a correlation in Microsoft Excel. Let's begin. Okay, now, there is a workaround here, and what we need to do. Okay, if we go to regression, and select that. So, we can obtain a p-value, this way. Now, what we will do, you can see there are two boxes here, input Y range, and input X range. So, for input Y range, we will go ahead, and select the exam grade value, and I'm also going to select the label, or the valuable name in the first row here. Okay, next, click in input X range box here, and then select hours studies and all the value there, and then, be sure if you do, select the variable name, as I have here, be sure select labels, okay, let's go ahead, and click OK, and then, here we get our output, I'm going to expand this little bit just to the values. We need there is a lot of information here, but I really only need a few values, and let's go ahead, and highlight those here. So, first of all, let's make this font a little bit bigger, so, it is easier to read. Alright, then we will expand. What we need here, now first of all if you see, we have just two variable, like we do in the correlation. Example where we have our studies, and exam grade. Then with two variables the multiple R is just identical to the Pearson R. So you can see, how this is also once again 0.86.
So, we could really just run regression to get our correlation. If you look under multiple R here, now, for the p-value, what we want to do is, we can go to the ANOVA table, and under significance here, this is our p-value, and it is very small there.
Okay, now, just in case you are interested, there is also the exact same p-value, when we have just two variables, also is under our studies, where it says, p-value. So, you can see, how two are the exact same here significance F, and p-value, they are identical. Now, what we are going to do here, we will use alpha 0.05, and the decision rule is as follows, if our p-value is, as given by the significance F, or p-value right here. If it is less than 0.05, then the correlation is statistically significant, and since 0.0001 is definitely less than 0.05, that indicates the correlation is in fact significant. Since this correlation coefficient of 0.86 is statistically significant, that means that there is a significant positive relationship between our studies and the grade on the exam, and we can go ahead and write the results as follows. There is a positive relationship between number of hours spent studies, and the grade on the exam, and then I have R, and that's for Pearson's R, 11, and that's equal to the degrees of freedom, where DF is equal to minus 2, and N is E equal to 13, so, 13 minus 2, is 11. So, R11 equals 0.86, and that was the value of Pearson's R, if you remember, and I put P as less than 0.001. Now, alternatively, you could put P as less than 0.05, if you wanted to. Now, this p-value gives us more information. It is more information than the p-value is less than 0.05. But since we used an alpha of 0.05 in this test, it would be acceptable to put p as less than 0.05, if we wanted to, but this does provide more information, and the reason why I said p is less than 0.001, is because if you look back our window in Excel our output, and this value is less than 0.001, and it is goes to 4 decimal places before the 1 appears, but it is not less than 0.0001. In any event, in most cases, when you see a p-value reported like this, is usually does not get smaller than less than 0.001. That about the limit where we report it in our written results.